morning children. So we have completed three chapters. Let us start with a new chapter, children, for 7A and 7B. That is he. So children, when we start speaking about he, we all know we should not touch any heat objects and all, because we get a shock from that. Children, heat is a such a kind of energy which can flow from one object to another object. Heat flows from one object to another object. It is a kind of energy. Okay, children. Heat, to make you understand, okay, children, we have one container called as A, one more container called as B, one more container or a beaker we can call it as C. In beaker A, I have taken hot water. In beaker B, I have taken cold water. In beaker C, I have taken normal water. See children, in this hot water, in this we are having cold water. In beaker C, I am having normal water. I will take my hands. Okay. In hot water, I will put my left hand. In a cold water, I will put my right hand, and I will keep like that only for 5 minutes. My left hand is in hot water, beaker. My right hand is in cold water, beaker. I will keep like that only for 5 minutes. Afterwards, I will remove it, and I will keep both my hands in the normal water. My hands start feeling like this. Left hand was in hot water, right hand was in cold water. When I keep it in the normal water, my both hands, this hand which was in the hot water starts feeling cold, and this hand which was in cold water starts feeling hot. Means the hand which was in hot water starts feeling cold, the hand which was in the cold water starts feeling hot. What I want to tell you here, children, is the hand which was in the hot water starts feeling cold, the hand which was in the cold water starts feeling hot. He, from this hand, is transferred to the normal water, and again that heat can be absorbed by the cold hand. In this hand was hot, it was in hot water. That heat will flow back to the normal water, and whatever the water is there in this, that heat is being transferred to the hand which was kept in the cold water. What I want to tell you here is, heat can flow from one object to another object. Heat can flow from one object to another object. It is such a kind of energy where it can flow from different objects. Then we have to tell here is the measurement of hotness of a body or an object. The measurement of hotness of an object or a body is called by the name, temperature. Temperature is what? It will give you the hotness or coldness, hotness or coldness of an object or a body. So, next is, like children, temperatures is measured by a device. Temperature is measured by a device called by the name called by the name thermo, by the name thermometer. Heat is one different concept, temperature is one different concept, that I will tell you when the concept comes in the top. Only thing now to understand here is, what is temperature? Heatness, hotness, hotness or coldness of an object is called as temperature. That temperature is measured by an device, an instrument called as thermometer. In thermometer here we have two types of thermometers too. Two types of thermometer. One is chemical thermometer, and one more is there, and one more is there, laboratory thermometer. Chemical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of human beings. To measure the temperature of human beings, not of any other objects, not the objects from the laboratory. It is used specifically to measure the temperature of only human beings. Which thermometer? That is clinical thermometer. Here I have a clinical thermometer, one diagram. It is one narrow, big, small, narrow glass tube. Sealed is inside sealed. Sealed tube is there. Okay? Sealed tube is there. Narrow glass sealed tube. Inside one small, like a small tube is there. That is a narrow, very, very thin tube is there. That tube is called as the, that tube is called as the capillary tube. It is inside the glass sealed tube. All this glass children, tube, glass tube, markings are there, readings are there. From 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. It is a measurement of the temperature of human beings. Okay, then here this part is called as the bulb. What? Bulb. This vent is called as the king. Okay, what liquid is there inside is mercury. It is mercury, red color mercury. It is the only one liquid non-metal. Only one liquid non-metal. Then we have to speak here is children. What I told you, mercury is a liquid. It is in the liquid form. Okay, liquid form. Here, when we keep this bulb under our arm or under our tongue, the temperature from my body, okay, the temperature from my body that is going to be transferred to the bulb. Okay, inside the bulb. Okay, again one more I am adding here. This part, okay, this is the small bulb which is of capillary tubes. In this small bulb I have a liquid called as mercury. Mercury, it's a liquid. So when my heat from my body is being transferred to the bulb, again further it is being transferred to the inside small bulb of the capillary tube. Okay, heat from my body is being transferred to the bulb, and energy is transferred to the small bulb here, which is of capillary tube. Inside this capillary tube, I have a mercury liquid. It gets heated up. It starts to melt slowly, and it starts to rise in the capillary tube. It will rise, and it will stop at a particular temperature. So that when it stops at a particular temperature in the capillary tube, so wherever it is going to go and stop, if it is going to go and stop at 38, okay, 38, 39, or 39.5, if it comes and stands here, means it shows the temperature of my, it shows the temperature of my body. That is like 39.5 degrees Celsius. If it is going to stop here, means I will write it as 39.5 degrees Celsius. This, children, degree Celsius is what is the unit to measure the temperature. It is the unit to measure the temperature. Unit to measure the temperature. So this was the all about the chemical thermometer, children. Then what are precautions I have to take while handling a clinical thermometer is, children, after the use of this clinical thermometer, I have to wash it with hot water, or I have to wash it, that clinical thermometer, after using, after measuring your temperature, we have to wash that with the antiseptic solutions, okay? Then we should not catch the bulb. You should not catch the bulb while we are keeping the thermometer in our mouth under the tongue, because the temperature from my body is going to be get transferred to the bulb. So we should not catch it by holding the bulb. We should catch it here in the middle. We should be very careful while handling it. Any mistakes, means it will get broken down. Then, because this is mercury, is a very toxic substance, children. While we are like seeing the temperature after the use, after we keep it in our mouth and we take it, I have one thermometer, children. Okay. So this is like bulb. A capillary tube is there, children, inside. Capillary tube is there. Outside we have a sealed glass tube. Sealed glass tube. Markings are there on the tube. Inside we have a very thin capillary tube. Mercury can rise in the capillary tube, and it will go and stop at a particular temperature. That shows the temperature of my body. Then when it stops, that is going to show the temperature of my body. Then, children, after we keep it under my tongue, okay, we catch it like this. We keep it under my tongue for 4 to 5 minutes, and I take it out. Then, when I have to see what is my body temperature, I should keep exactly to my side. So that if I keep it exactly to my side, I can see the where the mercury is stopped. I can see exactly what is the temperature of my body. So I should keep it exactly to my side. I should not hold it at the bulb. Handle it carefully, because it is a glass sealed tube. Wash this with antiseptic solution, Dettol and all. After using it, you should be very careful about the things. Then we should ensure that before use, the mercury level is 35 degrees Celsius. Before we are keeping this inside my mouth, under my tongue, I should confirm that the mercury level is at 35 degree Celsius. It should not be at 36, 37 degree Celsius. First only, it should be at below 35 degree Celsius before I keep the chemical thermometer under my tongue or in my under my arm. Then children, what I mean to tell, this 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius, this is the range of chemical thermometer. This is the range of chemical thermometer, means our body temperature cannot go below 35 degree Celsius and it cannot go above 42 degree Celsius. That is what the range of chemical thermometer, from 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius. That much markings only will be there in the chemical thermometer. What will be the markings? Only from 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius, that much readings are only there in the chemical thermometer. Okay children, then after we wash the thermometer with antiseptic solution, we should hold it tightly and we should use some jets we have to use, so that what can happen, these jets will bring the level of mercury down, ensuring that it falls below 35 degrees Celsius. Again, before using also I should give some jets, after using also the chemical thermometer I should give this chemical thermometer some jets, so that the mercury level is going to come below 35 degree Celsius. That's it. Then, so that somebody who is going to use it after my use, again they will wash this with antiseptic solution and they will ensure that the mercury level is below 35 degree Celsius and they can again use it to measure their body temperature. Somebody else, other people also. So, actually this chemical thermometer is specially designed to measure the body temperatures of only human beings, not for any other animals or for any other objects which are used in the laboratory. Then, I have to speak like children about laboratory thermometer, its range is, laboratory thermometers, its temperature measuring range is, is minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. This is the range of the measurement of temperature in the laboratory thermometer. Then the things are measurement of hotness or coldness of any object is termed as temperature. It is measured by a device called thermometer. Thermometers are of two types, chemical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometer's temperature range is 35 degree Celsius to 42 degree Celsius and the temperature range for a laboratory thermometer is minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. And how it works actually, chemical thermometer, how it is going to work? This and all, CL2 was there, glass tube, inside we had a narrow, very thin capillary tube, markings were there, readings on the glass tube, bulb was there, this is a small bulb of capillary tube was there, in that we had a mercury, liquid mercury was there, our body temperature is being transferred to the bulb, from that bulb it is going to get transferred to the inside smaller bulb and this melts and it is going to start, it is going to get raised in the capillary tube and this finally it is going to go and stop at a certain point. So that point is what the temperature of our body, how it works, that is what, how it works, this chemical thermometer. Then we spoke about how the heat can flow from one object to the other object. go from one object to the other object. That is what heat is, a kind of energy that can flow from one object to the other object. That is what I showed you by telling you, like taking the beakers, different types of beakers. Beaker A, beaker B, beaker C. Hot water was there in beaker A, cold water was there in beaker B, normal water was there in beaker C. That is what heat can flow from one object to the other object. The remaining things of this chapter, children, I am going to speak out in the next class. Thank you, children. And one thing, children, to make you to know about some different types of thermometers. We have one here, digital thermometer, children. We have here digital thermometer. How it actually works, digital thermometer, how it works at all. Okay, the things are where we can keep this needle under the arm. Okay, under the arm, I will keep it and show you, children. And you can show how this digital thermometer works. Actually rising, the temperature is rising in the thermometer, in this digital thermometer. You should hold it like this for 5 minutes so that I am going to get the temperature of my body. Just a show me, this is enough, children. Okay, it is now around 29 degrees Celsius, children. 29.8 degrees Celsius. 29.8 degrees Celsius. This is how we are going to use it. Okay, children. A digital thermometer. I am going to off it out now. Then we have like children. Fahrenheit scale. Fahrenheit thermometer. Fahrenheit thermometer. This is Fahrenheit thermometer. This is one different. Temperature scale. This is one different temperature scale, Fahrenheit scale. Okay, children, we have a bulb here. Okay, readings are there. When you come to the school, I am going to show and make you know how it really actually work. Actually, it is going to work. Okay, children. Then we have here one more thermometer, children. Okay. This is also Fahrenheit scale of temperature. Bulb is there, see, red color bulb is there. Readings are there on the glass tube. How it works and all, how it is actually there, how we can, people can catch it and see how it can work. When we come to school, we can see. Okay, thank you.